It was back on March 25th. I was getting ready to go to work, and it was about 11:30 a.m. in the morning, and there is a JCB that was coming from the opposite direction. So the JCB driver, he was talking on the phone. Instead of taking a turn, he just came straight towards us. And we did not have any place because we were right next to the wall. Since we did not have any place, my husband had to bend the bike. And when my husband bent the bike, the blades of the bulldozer cut my leg off and I was thrown on the road. The impact was so hard that it threw my husband like 30 feet away, and I was thrown right next to a pole that was there on the way.
Neelam is a 29-year-old IT professional who presented to us in March this year following a road traffic accident. She sustained an open injury to her right knee, which is a grade 3C open fracture, which basically involves a fracture of the knee with extensive soft tissue injury combined with injury to the blood vessels supplying to the knee.
And then when I turned and look, I can see my husband coming from like little far away distance. He was running and coming towards me, and all he did was he just asked me, "Are you okay?" And then I looked at him. When I realized, when I was trying to see from where the blood is coming, I can see my leg is just cut and the blood is oozing out from my veins. And then I just had no words. What am I supposed to be doing? My veins, my arteries, my bone, everything was like cut. Only little bit piece of my skin was still attached at the back. And then I can see people taking out my videos, my pictures, but there is no one ready to come help me. And I was so much in pain and agony that I was fading away. I was getting unconscious, but I kept telling to myself, I'm not going to be unconscious until I go to hospital, because I gave courage to myself saying that I need to deal with this and I need to come out of this. The moment I came here, they took me to emergency ward, Manipal Hospital Whitefield. They took me to emergency ward, and I can see like two, three doctors around me. I can't remember very well because I was half unconscious and I was just conscious halfway through.
She was immediately seen in the emergency department, and a combined approach, a multidisciplinary approach was applied. Plastic surgical team along with orthopedics and vascular surgical team were involved in the initial care of this patient. She was immediately taken to operation theatre within 3 to 4 hours of arrival, and a vascular repair was done, followed by plastic surgical input and external fixator application was done from the orthopedic department.
They did an X-ray for me, they did MRI scan, and then the radiology, and they did many scans, and then finally they told me that we are taking you to operation theatre, you will be given general anesthesia. I asked, will I be able to walk again? And then the doctor promised me, yes you will, I promise you that you will. That's when I relaxed myself that fine, no matter what pain I had to go through, I know that I'll get my leg back.
Later on, she recovered very well. She had multiple procedures during the stay of the hospital, during the hospital stay of about 10 days, during which the external fixator was readjusted, wound closure was performed by the plastic team, and then later on a definitive fixation was done after 4 weeks from the time of initial injury. She has developed. She gradually improved with the help of physiotherapy exercises, and she is now back to her regular activities now, following 4 to 6 months following the injury. And this clearly depicts that a prompt and multidisciplinary approach helps in limb salvage surgery. This is a classic example of how a team approach can give good results even in worst case scenarios.
But once I woke up from ICU, I can see my leg was like so much swollen, and I can see all the rods on my leg. They have given me external fixators. I thank Manipal Hospital Whitefield majorly that they're doing such a wonderful job. They're saving people's life, which is, after this accident, to me is such a big thing. It's only because of this hospital that I've got my leg back. I'm able to stand on my own feet today. It's only because of the hospital primarily, and then the doctors. Doctors here have done an amazing job. I would personally like to thank Dr. Anoop, Dr. Ramni, and Dr. V G Rajan majorly for giving me my leg back, for giving me my life back, literally, to tell